Hello to all my students out there. Since many of you requested me to solve the question answers for the first chapter of your chemistry syllabus, so here I am. So let us begin. Now the first question is, dash is used to increase the yield of a crop. Children, you must have heard that farmers use fertilizers to increase the yield of crop. So the answer will be fertilizer. The answer will be fertilizer. Fertilizer is used to increase the yield of a crop. Yes, food items like pickles and jellies are protected from bacteria by using dash. Now, whenever we are adding anything to food items to protect them from bacteria, it is called preservative because we are preserving them for a long time. We are protecting them from bacterias. So it is called preservatives. So the answer will be preservatives. All right. Now the next question is, water pipes are made up of? Water pipes are made up of PVC. Children, PVC is a kind of thermoplastic. Do you know what a thermoplastic is? It is the kind of plastic which can be remolded. All right, so PVC, water pipes are made up of PVC. Okay, dash chemistry deals with the study of carbon compounds. Very simple answer, organic chemistry. Organic chemistry deals with the study of carbon compounds. The elements present in talc are, okay, now talc contains three elements, and this you guys need to remember. What are the three elements? Magnesium, silicon, and oxygen. Okay, so you have to remember these three. Medicine which helps to control the body temperature is known as, if you guys have seen my video, I think you know the answer. Okay, antipyretics. Okay, like pyrogesic, calpol, all these are used for treating fever, that is controlling our body temperature. Right. Dash is a type of plastic which can be remolded. We just did this, right? Which plastic can be remolded, children? Thermoplastic. Now, if you're facing trouble in understanding the answers, what you need to do is, please go back to the video and see it once again. Okay, you'll get your answers. Now, choose the correct answer. Chemistry is a branch of science which deals with, I think all of you can answer this, right? The correct answer will be C, study of composition of matters. Medicine like penicillin and tetracycline is used as antibiotic, okay? So if the question comes like, give two examples of antibiotic, you can simply name these two, all right? Dash is a natural fiber, obviously cotton. Number four, the branch of chemistry which deals with physiological reactions. Children, the answer will be biochemistry. Biochemistry deals with physiological reactions. Now, coming to the long answer questions. The first question is, what is chemistry? Now, again, to understand the answers of this question, you need to go through the video, the lecture, which I have uploaded in my channel, okay? Still, I'm giving you the answers, okay? Now, what is chemistry? It is that branch of science that deals with the characteristics and composition of all substances along with the changes they undergo, all right? What it does, deals with the... I hope you're understanding my handwriting. I hope I'm... I know it's not very clear, but that's all I can do. Deals with the characteristics and composition of all substances, along with the changes they undergo, All right. Now, the next question. Mention four items of daily use which have the application in it. Okay, so which has the application of chemistry in it will be of chemistry. I have missed out. Okay, so we all know there are so many things which has the application of chemistry, right? We have done it already. Still, I'm writing it down over here. You can name soap. Okay, we also have detergents. Okay, we have the preservatives. We just talked about preservatives. So preservatives. Okay. There are only four, but you can name so many of them, right? Like you can say stain removers, fertilizer, pesticides, and it's uncountable. There are so many applications of chemistry in our daily life. If few of them are these, you can choose any four out of it, okay? Now, number three. State the difference between organic chemistry and analytical chemistry. Organic chemistry, as I told you earlier also, it deals with the study of carbon and its compound. Whereas analytical chemistry is that branch which deals with the qualitative and quantitative determination of the chemical components of substances. All right, this branch of chemistry is called analytical chemistry. Now, name the scientist who discovered hydrogen and oxygen gas respectively. Do you know who discovered hydrogen and oxygen gas? Hydrogen gas was discovered by Henry Cavendish. It was discovered by Henry Cavendish. Let me write it down here. Henry Cavendish. He discovered the hydrogen gas, all right? And oxygen gas was discovered by Joseph Priestley. Joseph, it must be given in your book, but still. All right. Now, define soap. Mention the difference between soap and synthetic detergent. Children, soap is made up of sodium or potassium salt of fatty acid. Okay, so you can simply say that soap is a sodium or potassium salt of fatty acids. And how are they prepared? They are prepared by boiling fats or vegetable oils with an alkali. For example, sodium hydroxide, it is an alkali. Potassium hydroxide, it is an alkali. Okay, so how soaps are prepared? They are prepared by boiling vegetable oils with alkali. All right. Now, coming to synthetic detergent. Now, when we talk about synthetic detergent, they have the cleansing action of soaps. Okay, but they become ineffective in hard water. So, synthetic detergents were developed because they are not effective. The soaps were not effective in hard water. All right. So, example of detergent is sodium lauryl sulfate. What is the example? Sodium lauryl sulfate. It forms enough froth with hard water, unlike the soap. Okay. Name two chemicals which is used as stain remover. Now, first of all, you need to understand what is stain remover. Stain removal is a process of removing a mark or a spot left by any specific substance on a fabric. Okay, some common stain removers are hydrogen peroxide, acetone, sodium hypochlorite. All these are stain removers. So remember, whenever they ask you the examples of stain removers, you can write hydrogen peroxide. Okay, this is one stain remover. Another one can be, you know, acetone. They have asked for two. I'm telling you three of them, sodium hypochlorite. And there are many more actually. Okay. So this is the answer for number six. Now coming to number seven. How chemistry is used in agriculture? Chemistry has a wide use in agriculture, children. Chemistry has helped farmers in various ways. They have helped the farmers improve the agricultural production by developing things like fertilizers, pesticides, insecticides, fungicides. All of these, what they do? They help in the better yield of the crops. Okay, so now you know how chemistry is used in agriculture. Do we have more question? Yes. Question number eight, what does it say? It says, what is philosopher's stone? Okay, do you know what is philosopher's stone? Philosopher's stone is an important substance and it was invented by ancient alchemists, okay, which has its use in the preparation of many superior metals like gold and silver. You all know gold and silver are such precious metals, na? So this philosopher's stone has its use in the preparation of superior metals like gold and silver, right? And who invented it? Ancient alchemist. Okay, so now you know what is philosopher's stone. Number nine, what is antacids? Give two examples. Oh my god, antacids find its use in our everyday life, almost in every home. Okay, it is used to neutralize the excess acid. What does it do? It is used to neutralize excess acid, all right, by which is released by gastric juice, released by the gastric juice in our body, right, in the stomach, basically in the stomach. Okay, so these are antacids. Okay, some example of antacids are, like, they are asking for two examples, so you can give milk of magnesia, and another example can be aluminium hydroxide. Okay, so these are two examples of antacid. And what are they used for? To neutralize excess acid, which is released by the gastric juice in the stomach. Now, the last question is, name the chemical present in antiperspirants. What are the chemicals which are used in antiperspirants? Children, when we say antiperspirants, we are basically either talking about any kind of talc or deodorants, right? So, if we talk about talc, we already did that there are three elements which are present in talc. What were the three elements? Can we just brush up? Magnesium, silicon, and oxygen, okay? And when we talk about deodorants, then we can say, we can name the chemical as aluminium and zinc salts. So children, that's all for today. If you need any kind of help, please mention it in the comment section. Do subscribe to the channel and share the video with your friends. I'll try to upload the PDF of the page in the description box. Take care and bye-bye.